we are going to take this computer and turn it into a Steam Deck. That is insofar as it'll be running Steam and using Proton in Linux. So let's get to it. Please don't get mad at me, I just needed a clever hook for this video. Asahi Linux is still not very mature, so its support is somewhat limited. The best place to get the most recent info and the most accurate info is to go to the Asahi Linux docs page, and this will be linked in the description of this video. Unfortunately, while recording this video, we're still only at M1 and M2 series support. This is because Asahi Linux's team has to largely reverse engineer all of Apple's hardware, and then write drivers for it. I am using an M1 Mac, so if I click the M1 series feature support page and scroll through it, we can see that it's largely supported for most features. As of recording this video, if I click on the M3 series support, you can see that almost everything is TBA, aka to be announced. The other thing you're going to need is a significant amount of free storage. On my SSD, I have about 800 gigabytes free, so I am in the clear. As far as I know, you cannot install this to an external drive. But if you happen to know otherwise, please let us all know down in the comments. This is not for the faint of heart, as you can break your Mac and then you'll have to do a DFU recovery, which requires a secondary Mac, and you'll lose all your data in the process. So please back up everything and know the risks. Now that we've covered that, let's get to the tutorial. Installing Asahi Linux is pretty easy. Just go to the official website and grab the curl command and paste it into a terminal. Just to explain what's happening here, curl is a command to download something off the internet. In this particular case, it's alx.sh, then followed by a pipe sh, which will execute this as a shell script. This will load the guided installer. The install process may change by the time you watch this video, but right now I only have two options, and one is to resize an existing partition to make space for the new OS, and the other is to quit. So arr, mateys it is.
I suppose I should apologize for that.
The next screen is a little confusing. You can see that I have a 2TB SSD and I have over 800 gigabytes free. It's complaining about a lot of overhead space being used, but I am not using Time Machine on this computer. I'm just going to effectively ignore the screen and hit Y. Basically, you need to decide on your partition size. The way the partitioning works is counterintuitive, at least in my mind. What you're selecting is how much of the partition will be dedicated to macOS, not the Linux partition. So for me, I wrote in 1500 gigabytes as I only wanted to dedicate 500 gigabytes to Linux. After this, it's a game of hurry up and wait. For me, it took about 2 hours for this to partition properly. Now I'm going to have to switch the camera because I was trying to save my video while it was repartitioning the drive and it did not like that. Not exactly surprising. But for other people, I've seen it go much faster. Once this is complete, you'll now have the option to install Linux into the free space. Press F to pay respect. Then you are given the options of what version of Linux you would like to install. KDE Plasma and GNOME are different GUIs. A very oversimplified explanation is KDE is more customizable and GNOME is not. I personally went with KDE Plasma, but either is a correct choice. After that, you can choose how much of your free space you want to use for your new OS. You'll probably want to use 100%. After that, give your OS a name and it'll start installing. Once it finishes installing, you'll be presented with another message. Notice that there are 7 steps here. The main gist is you need to fully shut down the computer, then hold down the power button to get the boot selector, and then select Asahi Linux. One sec, my screen's really dirty, so I'm using Whoosh to clean it off. This will boot up into recovery mode with the terminal window open. You'll need to punch in your password. Then you'll need to agree to putting a custom boot object into your permissive security, aka allowing it to boot Linux. There should be one more prompt on screen about creating your username and password. After this, you should be able to boot into Linux. The very first thing you'll want to do is launch your terminal and run sudo dnf upgrade. DNF is dandified yum, which is Fedora's package manager. It's basically how you install, remove, and manage software on Fedora Linux. This command will make sure everything is up to date, including grabbing the latest Vulkan drivers. Then you'll want to install Steam running sudo dnf install steam. This will most likely take a while, but once it's done, it should automatically launch Steam, and then, of course, you can log in. I originally did this out of order, installed Steam first, then updated, but it really doesn't matter. Now, here's something that you might not be familiar with because I wasn't, but when you first launch Steam, it won't be able to run Windows games out of the box. It didn't come in a box, but you get what I mean. To enable Proton, you need to go to Steam Settings, then go to Compatibility, then check Enable Steam Play. Steam will likely ask you to restart, so do that. I also had some minor issues, so I also reboot my computer, which seemed to help things along. Now you are able to install Windows games. Steam is a little glitchy in Asahi Linux, so I had to close and reopen it once or twice while using it because a download wouldn't start. So just be warned. Now, before you just start installing any game, you want to go to protondb.com and search it first. If a game's listed as not working here, it's definitely not going to work under this setup. Even then, it's not a full guarantee if the ProtonDB lists a game as working, they'll work under this Apple Silicon Mac configuration. I found this out with Far Cry New Dawn and Parkasaurus, the second game being super surprising since I've had luck with getting this working with Whiskey, Crossover, and Parallels. However, I was able to run Fallout 4 and Halo Master Chief Collection pretty well. First launches of games will take a little bit longer than subsequent launches because of compiling shaders. If you've used PlayStation 3 emulation, then you're probably familiar with this. One of the things you can do with Proton is use different versions. So if you right-click a game, go to Properties, and then click Compatibility, you can then force using a different version of the Steam Play. According to the ProtonDB, Parkasaurus should work with the latest experimental version of Proton. When you select a different version of Proton, it'll need to download. But when I tried to launch this game, it didn't work. As of recording this video, we've only had this ability for about 2 months now, so I wouldn't get too worried when your favorite game doesn't work. Give it some time, and most likely it will in the future.
Inevitably, people are going to ask me in the comments if their favorite game works in this configuration and with Proton, and my answer to everybody is, I don't know, but I know who does, and it's ProtonDB. Go there and check it out. This is going to take some geekery because not every game there is going to work with the Apple Silicon, as everything's very experimental and evolving very quickly. If you're looking for something that doesn't require installing a separate OS, I have an entire video on how to use Whiskey to play games, and it's been pretty popular. It's very short and to the point, just like this video. Lastly, I want to thank my Patreons, as always, for keeping this mid-roll ad-free. Thank you, guys.